So, in the last video, we made a gun, and the gun worked well, but there's one fundamental problem with it, and that's the fact that it's horribly inefficient. Because in a big game with many guns all firing bullets at the same time, we're going to be using a bunch of new part creations using instance.new. Now, I didn't write it specifically in my code, but the FastCast module utilizes instance.new to create new bullets based off of your cosmetic bullet template. And that's a problem because instance.new is a pretty costly function in terms of performance. But the creator of FastCast knew about this and he created a module called Part Cache. I have it in my toolbox right here. And you can get it in the description. It is a module that can basically create a bunch of parts, teleports them very high in our workspace, and then when we want them, we can request them and it'll set the C frame to like whatever we want. And then when we're done with the parts, we can return them back. So it's basically like a like local stasis chamber of the workspace. And it cuts down on your performance overhead quite a bit, and it allows you to get a lot more guns and a lot more bullets firing with less lag in your game, and that's great. So I'm going to take this part cache module, drag it into my gun, then navigate to gun server script right here. There's a few things we have to do. So first I'm going to start by defining part cache. And it's going to be equal to require tool dot part cache. There we go. And then I can go and below my cast params, I can say local bullet cache equals part cache dot new bullet template 100 bullets folder. So what this does is we create a new part cache with our bullet template. Remember, this is the part that we use for our bullets. Feel free to customize that to what you want. And then 100 is the number of parts we want to spawn in our cache. And this module can dynamically change the amount of parts, but it's recommended to get it at a good value that's not too high and not too low. And for my purposes, 100 is good. And then for our bullets folder, that's just where we want to store it, just parentage, just some logistical stuff. So then down in our cache behavior, we want to get rid of cosmetic bullet template because we don't really need. We need to be using that anymore. And instead, we're going to set the cast behavior dot cosmetic bullet provider and set that equal to our bullet cache. There we go. So that'll give this to FastCast and it'll be able to handle it all. So part cache and FastCast will be able to handle the creation of the bullet, but as for the deletion, we will have to implement that ourselves. So I'm going to go down to the onRayHit function, and instead of deleting the part by use of the debris service, I'm going to instead use a delay statement. Let's delay for 2 seconds, let's say, and we'll give it a function. So if you don't know what delay is, it basically waits a few seconds and then spawns this function in a separate thread so it doesn't yield anything. I'm not sure if this is necessary in this function, but we can leave it there just to be safe. And I know delay spawn, they're kind of crap, but for the sake of this video, we're going to use that just because they're pretty easy to understand. And all we have to do here is say bullet cache return part bullet. So this will return the part back to our little space stasis chamber in our workspace, which is exactly what we want to do. And that's really all the changes you need. So if I were to play this, you can see after a few seconds, all the parts disappear. And you can't really tell the difference because we only have one gun and one person. But if I were to go into the server, you can go to the bullets folder and you can see there's a ton of parts. And if we select this part, you can see it's way off in space. The Y is set to a very large number. That's basically how the module works. It's actually pretty cool. I think a cool challenge would be to implement that yourself. So go and try it out. And as a quick little bonus, I'm gonna go and make my gun fully automatic. You don't have to do this. I just thought this video is a little short, so I'll give you some extra cool things that you can do. So I'm going to go into my client script. Firstly, define user input service, local user input service equals game, get service, user input service. Then we're going to get run service, and this will be equal to game, get service, run service. There we go. So now we have user input service, run service. Instead of connecting tool.activated to this function, we're going to connect run service.stepped. So this will run every single frame, and then in order to prevent Argon from firing every single frame, we're just going to check if user input service is mouse button pressed enum dot user input type dot mouse button one. Now we're going to do then, and then we're going to go all the way down here and put end, and I'm going to indent just to make my code a little more readable. So this run service.stepped will run every single frame, and then user input service is mouse button press checks if our mouse button one, which is our left mouse click, is down, and then we just fire the server. So if we run this, we will have an automatic gun, and it looks pretty cool. I can blast away these zombies, little tiny zombies as well. And you'll notice, if I overload the system, part cache will start yelling at me and it'll start creating new parts. So keep in mind, when you are making these automatic weapons, it might be in your best interest to put a cap on the amount, or like maybe some ammo or something like that, just to prevent the module from lagging your game. But that's about it for this video. So I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe if you did. And in the next video, I'll be covering more gun things, such as animations or sounds, or just making the gun better. So other than that, hope you have a nice day, and goodbye.